I bid you welcome in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. And we are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before our God our brother Randy, and to give thanks for his life, to commend him to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. The service is printed for you in this worship folder, and you are bid to follow along. And if you wish, you may respond where appropriate, as marked in the bold print. And we'll be following that order. And our opening hymn that will follow the prayer of acclamation will be in the hymnals that are in front of you, starting with number 28. My friends, when we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him in baptism into death, so that Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. All who are baptized into Christ have put on Christ. In his baptism, Randy was clothed with Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, he should be clothed with glory. Let us pray. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. We glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you. Praise you. Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comfort of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. Let us sing together the Old Rugged Cross, number 28.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Randy. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and by hope, until by your call, we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. Here are these words of Scripture. Our first reading is from Psalm 24. The earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by false gods. They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from God their Savior. Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek your face, God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Lift them up, you ancient doors, and the King of glory may come in. Who is he, this King of glory? The Lord Almighty, he is the King of glory. Here ends our first reading. Our second reading is in the second letter to Timothy, the second chapter beginning at the 8th verse. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, descended from David. This is my gospel for which I am suffering, even the point of being chained like a criminal. But God's word is not chained. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they too may obtain salvation, that is, in Christ Jesus, with eternal glory. Here is a trustworthy saying. If we died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we disown him, he will also disown us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot disown himself. Here ends our second reading. And the Holy Gospel for this service of remembrance is from John's Gospel, the 16th chapter, beginning at the 31st verse and ending in the 17th chapter, the 5th verse. Do you now believe? Jesus replied. A time is coming, and in fact has come, when you will be scattered, each to your own home. You will leave me all alone. Yet I'm not alone, for my Father is with me. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world. After Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you. For you granted him authority over all people, that he might give eternal life to all those you have given him. Now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have brought you glory on earth by finishing the work you gave to me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began. The Gospel of the Lord. And now I'd like to invite Justin and Henry to the podium.
We'll see if I can get through it. I just want to thank everyone on behalf of our family for all the support we've received. It's truly appreciated. Again, that's for people watching, not just people here. But we've got a lot of support and we really appreciate it. It hasn't been an easy time on anybody, any of us. But I'm sure Dad's looking down and smiling at the massive amount of support that we've that's been extended. I have a few words actually from my Uncle Ron, Dad's older brother, and I just asked if he wanted to say anything as part of this. So he said that time spent with Randy was always a wonderful experience, full of humor and love. He was such a talented man with a huge heart, ready to help anyone. His biggest talent, though, was his storytelling, his tales of antics with the farm animals, the pig, the donkey wars, the rooster and the ducks, the fainting goats, the coal association meetings, and on and on. And if the stories weren't funny enough, he would do off-the-wall things like donning a helmet and having a bunting contest with the goats. Trudy and I were his biggest fans, and it didn't end with us. We often related his stories to friends around the campfire, and we would all die laughing. He and the farm were famous across four provinces that we lived. We miss him terribly, and he will live on in our hearts and memories. That was from Uncle Ron. This is my part now. I know as a young man, Dad found the love of his life in my mom, Tracy. This was his life partner, the one that stuck together through thick and thin. Side by side, they would stay together, although it was a conservative 23 years or so before they actually walked down the aisle. It was also at a young age that surprised they were pregnant with me. Mom and Dad soon had this young family, Graydon and myself, and he worked hard to support us as best as he could. And it must not have been very easy, but we all felt the love that he had for his family, and he set such a great example for us. Growing up, the door was always open on our home. The environment he and mom created were so welcoming. For Graydon and my friends all through school, ours was the place that friends always stopped in at any time or any meal. Dad's house and shop were always a second home to these friends. Everyone was welcome to stop in at any time. And even with the young family, there was still room in his heart for more kids. There are many people in our lives that started out as friends and were brought into our family, like surrogate children and brothers. They're always welcome in our home and our family. There was a pattern to be found here throughout his life. You would not be surprised to have people stopping in every 15 minutes when you're out at the farm, coming to drop things off, visit, hang out in the shop, or whatever. He picked up friends of all ages. Pretty much wherever he worked, wherever he spent time, he made an impact in people's lives. He loved to tinker on anything, burning wood, coal, waste oil, baling, tinkering on boats, small motors, big motors. Dad loved to work. He loved to work with his hands and to fix, and he loved Kijiji a little bit. Later in life, he found his love of boating as well, and he loved to spend time down at the river with friends and family, having a few drinks and barbecuing off the back of his pontoon boat. The grandchildren were also the center of his world. He simply loved spending time with them, cuddling with them on the couch, spoiling them at every opportunity. I know he was sneaking cans of pop out there in the garage to them too when we weren't looking. And just recently, he even saved me when a work emergency popped up and I asked if they could watch the kids. And at the drop of a hat, he offered to come pick them up, anything to help. That was the kind of heart that he had. I thank God for such a man, such a father, and a presence in our lives, and for affecting so many people. I'm going to miss him so much, and I know that all of you will be doing the same. And then I have actually a poem that Henry wrote here, which I don't think he's up for coming up to share, but I'll try and do it justice, Henry. So, Memories by Henry Sinchina. I hold my memories in my heart, but every day we have to part, but then I remember my memories. Some of my memories are drinking soda in the garage and driving his bota. Then in the garage, the floor is greasy and the air is gassy, and under the skidoo, the broken skidoo is Grandpa. But as the years go by and Grandpa died, the garage's greasy floor and gassy air is no more. And so in my heart, and so I hold my memories in my heart, and every day we have to part, but then I remember my memories. By Henry. It was very nice. Thank you all for all the support you've given.
Thank you, Justin. Thank you, Henry. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, we've been born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Amen. Tracy, Graydon, Justin, and family and friends, after hearing what was just said, I'd like to throw out what I've written. It's absolutely beautiful. But I'll do the best I can. A few years ago, I was called to the hospital, and where I encountered two teens who had just lost their father. And one of the teens said to me, "Why does this hurt so much?" That's a jaw dropper. But I said, "The reason it hurts is we love. We love too much. We loved what we were receiving, what we were getting. And now we feel deprived. We feel that it won't be there any longer. And we'll miss this love. And this love makes us feel alone. But that's not true. What a great gift that Randy has given each of you. And now it's your turn. You have to take what Randy gave you, make it your own, and share that with others in your journey on life. It's not easy, but as we practice that, it gets easier. That's something I think we've all had to learn, many of us had to learn in our own life journey at this time. But that question that was asked is a good one to ponder. And it's very similar to the question that was asked in our gospel reading that was chosen today by Justin. Because what Jesus is doing is he's preparing his disciples for his crucifixion, his death, his resurrection, and ascension to heaven. These disciples who loved Jesus very deeply are now going to be left alone. At least so they thought. He says some of his disciples will leave Jesus. It'll appear that Jesus has been abandoned and left alone. But this abandonment is not an absolute reality, because Jesus says, "Yet I'm not alone, for my Father is with me." And there is a bond here that cannot be broken, even by death. God the Father is with his Son. And in our readings, it says God the Father, or God, is with his people, even in death. We declare, prior to this service, we declare in the word that we began with, that God is with Randy. In those famous words of Psalm 119, "Where can I go? Where can I flee from you? If I make my bed in the grave, you are there. You are with me." God's presence is remaining. God's love is remaining. Why? In this world, you will have trouble. But he says, "But take heart, I have overcome the world." By this scripture that we have before us, yes, this is troubling, but he's overcome it and has given us a new hope, a future hope. As pointed out, Randy is a family man, showed and poured out much love on family, grandchildren, especially wife and sons. And there is a bond here that cannot be broken, even in death. And that is the gift of Randy's love. A love that remains in each of you. It's a love that you were taught. It's a love that he showed you by demonstration. It's a love that he showed in how he interacted with others. And we need to remember what he did. As pointed out by Uncle Ron, he said he was never too busy to help someone. That is demonstrating love for neighbor. He treated various people like a family member, and that is love. As Justin pointed out, that door was always open to them, and that is love. Love overcomes loneliness, abandonment, and grief. And this love is something that cannot be taken away. Perhaps forgotten, maybe set aside, but in reality, it's still there. In a time like this, we are called to remember what Randy has given each of you, and remembering this day, the positive aspects of Randy's life, that gift of personhood, as well as those physical tools, those hands-on things that Randy did for his friends and his neighbors. He even taught me a few tricks of the trade, the odd fix-it on my old lawnmower. You must also remember what Christ promised to Randy in his baptism and those who embrace Christ as Savior. In John 17, it's written, "For you granted him, Jesus Christ, authority over all people, that he might give eternal life to those you have given him." The baptized belong to Christ and are promised eternal life. Randy is baptized, and this promise belongs to him. And again in John, we hear those familiar words, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. We Christians have a peculiar belief. We have an Easter belief that the dead in Christ shall be raised to eternal life on the last day. And we entrust Randy. We entrust him to that great and precious promise to the resurrection. Matter of fact, we will profess that same belief in the words of the Apostles' Creed, which we'll recite together later on. Now, Randy was a frequent customer at the Oak Bluff Petro, where I worked in my early retirement days. And I think, I hope I have this story straight. But it was a little bit crowded, a lot of people. He'd come in, and I had my back, and I was doing something with the cash. And he said, "Well, Pastor Vert," he says, "you're practicing with the offering plate again, aren't you?" So we kibitzed a little bit about that. After Randy left, several people said, you're a minister? Would you bless my lottery ticket? Randy started that. But also, too, he is an honest man. There were times he corrected me if I made a mistake, perhaps, in giving him change, too much, perhaps. Or maybe I didn't charge him enough for coffee. But he had a great sense of humor, and he loved to tease. He also was told, there was also one story, Graydon and Justin, you're going to have to help me out on this one. If I remember right, I think the grandkids would hide. And if he wanted to find out where they were, he said, "Whose candy bar is this?" And they would come running. Is that correct? Did Grandpa do that?
Several kids.
Sir. I'm sure now if Randy found a $20 bill, he'd say, "Who had the $20 bill?" And people would come running. In our first reading of Psalm 24, the psalmist declares that the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. And these scriptures many times assert that we human beings belong to the Lord our God. We belong because we are part of the earth, and God created the earth. Time and again, through the prophets, through Christ, the apostles, the scriptural call has come reminding us that we belong to God and our life does not end. And as we keep faith in Christ, and then the sacrament of holy baptism is given to us as a sign, a symbol, and a mark on our heads that we belong to Christ. And in Christ we have hope and promise of the resurrection to eternal life. Baptism is a dying and rising to new life, eternal life in Christ. God in Christ has done this out of love for you and for Randy. Again, in 2 Timothy verse 8, it says, "Remember Jesus Christ raised from the dead, that if we died with him, we will also live with him." We are entrusting Randy to this very peculiar promise, a hope-filled promise, because God so loved the world. And Randy demonstrated and reflected the love of family and friends that words, and my words especially, cannot adequately describe. Family, you remember the best. You know how Randy gave you his love, that gift of personhood, and he showed you how to use them in life with heart and hands. Now, as you gather later today, reflect upon these gifts, celebrate them, and use them to move forward in healing as you live out your life. For now we stand in the shadow of Good Friday, that old rugged cross, looking forward to the fullness of the Easter victory when Christ comes again, raising his people to eternal life. For we are saved by grace through faith in Jesus Christ. It's an amazing grace. Amen. Let's arise and profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope to your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, that they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage, and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy, help us in the midst of things we cannot understand to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And Lord, as you taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us commend Randall Williamson Chinna to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Randy. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. A reading. The 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me to lie down in green pastures beside the still waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in the right pathways for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the darkest of valleys, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Let us sing together now, Amazing Grace. The opposite now, isn't it? It's the opposite. I think it's number 28, I believe.
On a hill far away, stood an old rugged cross. The end of suffering and shame, and I love that old cross where the tears and dust for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till I grow.
Let us go forth in peace, in the name of Christ. My friends, none of us lives to himself and none of us dies to himself. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Let us pray. Almighty God, by the death and burial of Jesus, your anointed, you have destroyed death and sanctified the graves of all your saints. Keep our brother, whose body we now lay to rest in the company of all your saints, and at last raise him up to share with all your faithful people the endless joy and peace won through the glorious resurrection of Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lo, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet shall sound, and we'll all be changed, raised imperishable. For this imperishable nature must put on the imperishable, and this mortal nature must put on immortality. When the perishable puts on the imperishable, and the mortal puts on immortality, then shall come to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In a sure and certain hope to the resurrection to eternal life, our brother Randall Williamson Chinna, we commit his body to its resting place. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious unto him. The Lord look upon him with favor and give him peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus, by your death you took away the sting of death. Grant to us, your servants, so to follow in faith where you have led the way, that we may at length fall asleep peacefully in you and wake in your likeness. To you, the author and giver of life, be all honor and glory now and forever. Amen. Rest eternal grant him, O Lord, and light perpetual shine upon him. And now again, may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us go in peace.